this final video of the three-part series on honeybee stings, I'm going to be discussing your response to the sting, as well as how to prevent stings for yourself, but also other individuals around you. First, the response. When you get stung, that muscular bulb is pumping venom from the venom sac through the sting shaft into your body. The longer that sting remains in your body, the more venom you're going to get in your body. The more venom you get in your body, the greater response your body is going to have to the sting. So the first response to a bee sting is get it out as quickly as possible. When you get stung, scrape it out. It does not matter how you remove it, just remove it. There's been this long-term debate on whether you should scrape a sting or pinch and remove a sting. If you're working with bees and you get stung, you could always lightly smoke the area. When a bee stings you, she deposits alarm pheromone around that sting, which tells other bees to sting you in the same place. So you will often see beekeepers smoking themselves after a sting attack just to mask those alarm pheromones. The next thing you need to do is note your body's response to the sting. Is it just painful and that's it? Well, you can keep on doing your thing. But are you starting to feel that your throat's closing or you're getting sweaty? That's a completely different response. Most beekeepers at this point will simply scrape the sting and move on. They might get dozens or maybe even hundreds of stings. But if for some reason you have reason to believe that your body is responding to a sting in a way that's not okay, seek medical attention. A lot of medical professionals will tell you to wash the sting site to prevent infection, ice the sting site, and if you're having a big response, perhaps even take an antihistamine. But it's very important to follow your medical professional's recommendations. I'm not a medical professional. All I can do is report to you some of the common responses. When in doubt, speak to your allergist. A lot of beekeeping supply companies will sell topical sting aids that you can simply rub on top of the sting. But as I noted earlier, most beekeepers who've been stung any number of times, the sting is just a nuisance. They scrape it out and they continue on with their business. So that's how you respond to a sting. What do you do to prevent stings? Well, I always tell people if you are working bees, you should wear personal protective equipment. That, of course, includes the veil, the gloves, maybe the bee suit. Stings on the arms and the wrists and the legs aren't quite as problematic to me. But think about it this way. It might take a lot of stings on your arm to elicit a significant body response, but it may only take a few stings around the nose and throat area to elicit that same response. Keep in mind also that when bees get very defensive, when their defensiveness starts to escalate, they tend to sting areas where you emit carbon dioxide as well as areas that are dark. That's why a lot of personal protective equipment is white, as an example. So if you're not wearing a veil and you rile up a bee colony, the bees might concentrate their sting in a very sensitive area. So I always put on a bee veil. Ultimately, the amount of personal protection equipment that you want to wear is up to you, but I would at least recommend that you wear a veil. Never approach a colony unless you are fully ready to work it. And that includes wearing that aforementioned personal protective equipment, but also having a smoker. The purpose of a smoker is to mask honeybee alarm pheromone to reduce the defensive response, therefore the number of stings that you will get while working a colony. So always have a smoker lit and ready to go with you when you approach colonies. Another thing to think about with colonies is bees do not like intense vibrations, loud noise, exhaust. Anytime I cut grass or weed eat close to my bee colonies or do any type of heavy equipment operation around bee colonies, I wear at least a veil. You're not going to hear the bees coming because you're going to be running loud equipment, so you want to have your head and neck protected in the event that you are attacked. It's generally a good idea that you minimize the amount of loud scents that you wear. In other words, you don't want to perfume or cologne yourself to death before working a bee colony. You need to be very conscious of the type of hairspray and things that you use as you're around bees. And kind of keeping in line with this, when you're around bees, you do want to wear light colors when you work bees. Again, that's why a lot of personal protective equipment's white, but you'll see people forget that when they wear black boots or have black socks that they tuck their bee suits into. So in those cases, you need to be aware that bees might sting those areas. So it might be better to have lighter colored shoes or lighter colored boots or lighter color socks that you're going to use in the apiary. Another thing that's a really important consideration when you work colonies is bees that are beginning to express heightened defensive behavior will start to respond to sudden, quick jerks and movements. I always tell people, when you work a bee colony, it's almost like conducting an orchestra. Plant your feet, because you don't want to squash bees that might have fallen on the ground, and make very purposeful, slow, methodical movements. Sudden jerks can give bees targets to chase. If you find yourself being attacked by multiple bees, don't swat. People love to swat at bees. Bees cannot see well, so when you are swatting them, you are basically showing them where you are and you are inviting stings. The final thing I want to discuss with you is the appropriate public response to bee stings. Remember, you're a beekeeper. You're going to get stung. We've talked about how to remove the sting, how to clean the site, how to prevent stings for yourself by wearing personal protective equipment. But as a beekeeper, you're going to find yourself discussing bees and bee stings with the general public. I find myself doing that all the time. And the recommendations I give to the general public about experiencing bee stings is slightly different than the recommendations I give to beekeepers about bee stings. So this next set of rules deals specifically with folks who aren't beekeepers but find themselves close to bees. Number one, again, when you're getting stung in volume, the bees are telling you you're too close to their colony. They don't want you here. Get away. So the best thing you can do is leave the area as quickly as possible. Even if you don't see a colony, the fact that you are being stung 2, 3, 4 or more times tells you that you're too close to the nest. Remember again that bees concentrate their stings in sensitive areas, dark areas, carbon dioxide emitting areas. So we tell folks all the time at our lab, in an emergency response, pull your shirt over your nose and your mouth because you're going to want to be breathing. Bees are going to be flying. You might breathe them into very sensitive areas. You can either do that with your hands, you can pull up your shirt, but the key is to get away. Get away as quickly as possible. A lot of people make the mistake by jumping into water. You see that on cartoons all the time. Don't jump into water. Really aggravated colonies will hover around the water just because they last saw you go there, and when you come up for air, you might inhale bees. Don't jump into water. Leave the area as quickly as possible. Whenever you have a chance to get inside of something, people often make this mistake too. They'll jump into a vehicle, but they'll have bees all over them, so they're worried about having bees in the vehicle, but they jump back out of the vehicle where there's hundreds of bees potentially. So you're going from a few bees to a lot of bees. When in doubt, cover your airways, get away from the area as quickly as possible. If you have a shelter, get into it and stay there until the bees calm down. If you follow these steps, you'll have years and years of beekeeping enjoyment, but I have to say this last piece of advice. It is possible to keep bees your entire life and later in your beekeeping career to become allergic to bees. So you do want to do things that are necessary to minimize the number of stings that you get, and that will prolong your beekeeping years.